Welcome back to another tutorial from PowerDirector Made Simple. Today's video will show something about a recent comment posted to my videos about the use of magic cuts. It has bounced around from one menu to another, but it's still there in PowerDirector 365. You just have to know where to find it. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there, so let's get started. I asked Copilot this question: what is the purpose of magic cuts? It responded, "The magic cut tool is ideal for condensing long video segments into shorter clips. For example, magic cut can edit a 1-hour video down to 10 minutes. It utilizes video technology that locates and keeps the most interesting moments while discarding sections of lesser importance." Now, according to Copilot, Magic Cuts is capable of about an 85% reduction of a video file. Now, remember that bold statement because we're going to check that out in this tutorial. There are some limitations to the functionality of Magic Cuts. First of all, it has changed over the years and now can only be applied to one video clip at a time. So right away, you might be thinking about that video you recently took while on vacation, which turns out is really nothing but a whole bunch of short, unedited clips. How do I make magic cuts apply to all of those clips? Unfortunately, selecting all of the clips at the same time while they are on the timeline won't work, so the quick workaround is to merely export them all to create one big temporary video clip that you can bring right back into PowerDirector and then apply magic cuts to that one temporary video clip. For example, on my timeline are 13 total clips taken at Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk in California. The total duration time is just under 4 minutes, but much of it is somewhat redundant scenery shots that just take too long to look at. Moving the playhead over to the final clip, notice the video of the moving pirate ship ride. Make a note of that, as we'll be checking for it in the newly created video. I'm going to click on Export and create a new video clip that I'll call Santa Cruz Temp. Now, when the rendering is done and I'm back at the main window, I'll clear out the timeline and place that one large temporary clip on the timeline. Now let's see if Magic Cuts can make a better video out of this. I'll select the clip, then click on the More Features icon just above the timeline. Then I'll select Edit Video and choose Magic Cut. Or it's just as easy to just right click on the clip and select Edit Video and then choose Magic Cut. The window for Magic Cut opens and you'll start out in the Duration tab, which shows the original duration and the new duration, which can be changed basing on either how you want it to appear, how much background music you want, or how you want the cuts to appear when you set them in the next tab, Criteria, which we'll get to in just a minute. Now notice that before we have made any preference changes, Magic Cuts gives us a supposed recommended new duration time of 1 minute, 17 seconds, and 2 frames, which works out to be about 1/3 of the original length. Now remember that proportion because we'll come back to it later. There is also the opportunity to add background music, but for the time being, I want to keep the original audio with no additional background music, and I am happy with the new duration time of 1 minute, 17 seconds, and 2 frames as suggested. We'll also come back to the background music in just a bit. But first, some important stuff and a very serious pitfall about magic cuts that you need to avoid. Now, right now, I need to consider whether or not to have transitions, what kind they should be, or not to have them at all. I'll stick with the fade transitions for now. In a moment, you'll find out that this is a mistake because I'm trying to keep my original audio at the same time. Now, next is the Criteria tab, which is where you make the choices that determine when and where the cuts will be made and what kind of video objects or motion you want to include in the cuts. I'm going to turn down the scenes with zoom and pan. I'll turn up the scenes with moving objects. I'll turn down the scenes with people and people speaking, because there were people almost in every scene. And supposedly, if I want everything to be fast-paced with lots of cuts, I'll turn down the duration of the scenes. Next, I'll click on Preview. The AI will take a short while to analyze the video clip and figure out what can be cut. That time will be almost the same as the duration of your clip. I'll speed forward for the next minute or so until it is done. Now, when finished, the new clip immediately starts to play and I can hear a problem that was created. Every time there is a cut with a transition, the original audio momentarily fades out. Apparently, whenever a transition is applied through Magic Cuts, it applies to not only the video, but also with a crossfade to the audio track. Now, this would not be a problem if I had silenced the audio in the original clip and was listening to only the background music. I'll go back to the Duration tab and turn off the transitions. I'll click on Preview once more, and because it's already been analyzed, it doesn't take long at all this time. Now, when the new clip plays, I like the clean cuts as it preserves the original audio as much as possible. But there is still one other major problem. I'll move the playhead towards the end of the clip and notice that it ends with an aerial shot, but the scenes of the swinging pirate ship ride have been eliminated entirely. How strange. I'm going to close Magic Cuts and go back and look at the original video to see how far Magic Cuts actually included in the new clip. As I slowly move the playhead through the clip, I'll stop at around the 220 mark. This is as far as Magic Cuts look at of the entire 4-minute video. Everything to the right of the playhead was completely ignored. What the heck is going on here? Is it a problem that I didn't make the new duration long enough? And if so, then just how long should I have made the new duration to ensure that everything was included? Well, after some experimentation that was done previously, I need to move the new duration up to around the 2-minute mark in order to force Magic Cuts to look at everything. I'll start up Magic Cuts. I'll change that duration to the 2-minute mark. I'll turn off transitions once again. And then I can click on Preview once more. When the revised clip begins to play, I can move the playhead towards the end where the missing scenes are now thankfully found. So instead of that 85% reduction in duration, a more realistic size of 50% or less is what you can really expect. Now, don't you find it amazing that all those other content creators posting tutorials about Magic Cut and PowerDirector, which shows some amazing reduction in duration times, have not caught on to the fact that their new video is ignoring a lot of the original video? You'd think that naturally Magic Cut would include everything, but it doesn't. They don't bother to really look at what Magic Cut does and does not accomplish. Now that's what is amazing. Well, now that we know that we need to have an output duration of around 2 minutes or more for this clip to make sure that the scenes for this clip are not overlooked, let's throw some background music into the mix. On the Duration tab, you can add background music of your choice, but the choice has to be made through a Windows Explorer box and is not chosen from your media library in PowerDirector. It seems like Magic Cuts knows nothing of PowerDirector's media library, but instead relies upon Windows File Explorer to locate and open files. And no other content creator thought this to be just plain strange? I'll just click on the Add Music button and select one music file in my project folder called Aloha Summer. Now, once the music file is added, you should know that the music is 2:03:23, which is longer than what I have manually increased the new duration to be, which is only 2 minutes even. If I keep things as they are, the music will be just cut off at the end. I have another choice to fit the duration to the music. I'll click on that button, and the new duration jumps up to 203.23 to match the music. I'll also make sure that transitions are turned off once again. Now, before I proceed to the preview again, you should notice another shortcoming of Magic Cut in that there is no preview of the selected music files once added to the sequence. So you'll need to preview them ahead of time and make your choices accordingly. So when I click on preview once again, the new clip is generated almost immediately and begins to play. The original audio and new background music are playing as desired. I'll stop the playhead and move it to the ending to make sure no content was ignored. And because our new clip is at least 50% of the original, sure enough, the ending scenes were present. So everything seems fine so far, so I can now finally click on Apply. And now you can see where the new video replaced the old video and where the actual cuts were made. Some new clips are only 5 seconds long, while others are about 14 seconds. You should also realize that what started as over 4 minutes of a video clip has been reduced to just about 2 minutes, and yet it conveys the same imagery and environmental sounds. Keeping things short and to the point are what keeps the viewer's attention. Now, one other important thing to remember is that Magic Cuts doesn't create an ending or closing of any type, so you may have to do some minor editing on the last clip to have both the video and the audio fade to black or add your own closing title. And remember, when I said to remember that 1/3 size that Magic Cut seems to come up with automatically, I've done some testing on multiple different durations of video clips, and each and every time Magic Cut comes up with a new duration time that is exactly 1/3 that of the original. This is regardless of how complicated the clip may be or how many different scenes are in that clip. The 1/3 proportion is apparently hard-coded into the program. There is no magic in that. Wow, all these years and nobody has ever bothered to check. You gotta be kidding me. To this day, there still are other YouTube tutorials out there claiming that the audio track is king on Magic Cuts, and it will determine your video length. Well, yes, that may be true if you want to ignore the fact that the new video could be missing much of the ending content from the original clip. And that up to 85% reduction that Copilot said was possible, it's more like 50% at best. And finally, as you look at my screen, you may be wondering, just where is that background music that was added? It's down at the bottom where PowerDirector added an audio track below the last track on my screen. If I wanted to make things look neat and tidy, I could right-click in the track area on the far left and select Remove Empty Tracks just to bring it up to the top. I'll hit Ctrl-Z to undo that, because another method is to just grab that audio clip and move it up to the next available audio track at the top. You should consider playing around with Magic Cut on any old video clip that you have lying around just to test it out to see how effective it can be. Try using a long video of 20 minutes or more, and try using Magic Cuts with a new duration that will be less than 50% of the original. And then check to see if Magic Cut included everything or left the ending out. Then, if you like it, try it on some of your family vacation videos that probably put everybody to sleep after the first 5 minutes. My overall impression of Magic Cut is that, yes, it can be helpful, but you need to know all about its limitations and quirks. Otherwise, you could be losing lots of your video without even realizing it, like so many other similar brain-dead tutorials that are out there. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If so, give it a like. And make sure you click that subscribe button. And as always, I thank you for taking the time to watch. I'll see you on the next one.